Radiant Wanderings. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button and stay a while. And as always, if I go too fast in this video, you can look in the description below and there will be a link to my blog post on this topic with any of the links that I reference as well throughout the video. And also, if you find anything in here helpful or useful, please give a big thumbs up, hit that like button, and that would really help me out. Thank you guys so much. All right, so today we are talking about Whitefish, Montana. This is part of my Moving to Montana, Flathead County, Montana moving guide. And today we are discussing the wonderful city of Whitefish. It is a beautiful little town, quaint and fun, and has so much to offer. So let's get into it. All right, so Whitefish, Montana surpassed 8,500 residents in 2020. It's grown over 35% in the last decade. And it's easy to see why. Whitefish, Montana has plenty of shopping and dining, art galleries, fishing, hiking, kayaking, paddleboarding, cross-country skiing, snowshoeing, downhill skiing, beaches, restaurants, and more. Additionally, they also have Whitefish Mountain Resort and ski and snowboard here. So in this moving guide, I'm just going to discuss housing costs, schools, recreation, amenities, and the pros and cons of choosing Whitefish, Montana over a different city in Flathead County. And as always with any of these moving guides, I'm giving you the best information that I know how currently. However, please do check with a real estate agent before moving here, as districts, school districts might change, ratings, numbers, all of that good stuff. All right, so the median home price for Whitefish, Montana is $450,738. That's according to Zillow.com right now. And that again just means that half of the houses that are listed for sale are listed above that price and half of them are listed below. If you watched my Kalispell, Montana video last week, you'll notice that's a bit higher. That's a pretty big increase, over $100,000 higher than what is the median price in Kalispell currently. So you are definitely going to pay a bit more in housing costs to live in Whitefish. You're also going to pay a bit more in property taxes and utilities, groceries. Whitefish, Montana, just like all of Flathead County in Montana, doesn't have a sales tax, but they do have a tourist tax of 3%. So if you're moving from somewhere else, that's still great. I'm sure that's less than your sales taxes. But for those of us that live in Flathead County, anytime I go to Whitefish and I have that 3%, I'm like, dang it, it's not a big deal. But it's definitely something to be aware of. And as far as commute time goes for Whitefish, Montana, it's just 19.1 minutes, average is 26.4. So you're still coming in pretty good on your commute time. As far as transportation goes, the Amtrak comes right into the Whitefish Depot, right downtown Whitefish. So that's really convenient for any visitors or family that you might have coming to stay with you. It's the Empire Builder Line, and it runs from Chicago all the way to Seattle several times a week now. It used to be more, I think, for COVID, they just took it down to 3 times a week, but it's still a great option for anybody that's coming from east to west, west to east. And as far as local transportation is concerned, the local residents can hop on the Tri-City Commuter bus line to get from Whitefish to Columbia Falls to Kalispell, and then that bus line also goes throughout downtown Kalispell once they get into Kalispell. So that's an option there. Again, those are ADA accessible, they all have lifts, and they're about $1 each way, so very affordable. And then Whitefish residents have the added benefit for play of the snow bus. Don't be deceived by the name. It actually runs in summer and winter. It probably started just in winter for Whitefish Mountain Resort. But now that they have the summer activities up there as well, it will take visitors and residents alike and whisk them up to the mountain for a day of fun. It's free of charge. They have quite a few stops in downtown Whitefish. So I will put a link in my blog post below if you want to look at any of those transportation options and where they pick up and drop off. And as far as schools are concerned, the public school system, you're going to have Whitefish Middle School, which is a 7 out of 10 rating, and then Whitefish High School, which is an 8 out of 10 rating. As far as ratings in Flathead County go, these are some of the best. All right, and let's get into recreation. I mean, let's face it, that is why most people come and want to live and stay in Whitefish, Montana. So City Beach, it's a great little sandy beach area where you can just soak up the summer sun. It has paddle boards and kayaks for rent there. If you have your own because you live locally, you can just put them in at the boat dock there and push on out and just paddle around the lake, or you can just head right into the Whitefish River there and go on down for a little jaunt for the day, which is really nice. They also have a deck there, Sweet Peaks ice cream, and I believe you can buy some hamburgers and hot dogs and just sit out on the deck and just enjoy the mountain views over the lake. It's a really beautiful beach to be at. Whitefish Lake is absolutely beautiful. If you prefer a different beach area, there is Les Maisons. I don't know if that's how you say that, state park. However, that's not a sandy beach. That's just all rocks along the east side of Whitefish Lake. And then there's Whitefish Mountain Resort, which I mentioned briefly. So in the summer at Whitefish Mountain Resort, you have zip lining, the aerial adventure park, the alpine slides. You have the Danny on trail, which you can hike on up. And they also have mountain biking there, lots of mountain biking trails. And then of course you can take a chairlift or a cable car up to the summit, grab a drink or some lunch at the restaurant there, and just enjoy the beautiful mountain views. And then in the winter, of course, you have skiing and snowboarding, epic powder days up there. The backside usually opens first, and then the front side opens a little later in the season. The season usually begins December 8th, around there, and then it's around April 8th. So it's not as long as some, but it's definitely plenty long enough. Ski days begin around 9 a.m. and end around 4:30. And then of course there's the after skiing, drinks and food. Okay, so Blanchard Lake, I just recently found out about, and it's really nice. However, it doesn't have a picnic area or a beach area or anything. But if you have paddleboards and kayaks, you can go and put in at the fishing access area. And it's a very peaceful lake with the lily pads and just beautiful mountain views. There are some homes along the lake here, and it's just really, really nice for a day of fishing or just relaxing on the lake. You could bring tubes here. Some people were swimming, although I wouldn't swim in it. But you know, children don't really know the difference. So it's definitely a really, really nice lake to check out. And then you have the Whitefish Trail System. The Whitefish Trail System has over 42 miles of trails spread out over 12 different trailheads for hikers and bikers, for equestrian horseback riders. You can definitely check out these different trails. Many of them have beautiful summit views that reward the enthusiast as they get to the top. So definitely check out the Whitefish Trail System. And then located adjacent to the Whitefish Trail System is the Whitefish Bike Retreat. They have 19 acres. They have a bike park there for beginner to advanced. So you can stay at the resort or you can just visit for a day. Residents can get a season pass here to brush up on their skills. So definitely don't miss that. And then there's Bar W Guest Ranch. And while this is typically for visitors, they do offer horseback rides in the summer, sleigh rides in the winter. And then they also offer boarding for horses, horseback riding lessons, and they do rent out their grounds for weddings and receptions and larger parties and events. And then there is dog sledding. I did share some of the dog sledding in my Whitefish Montana East Day Shot Play video. It is a lot of fun. It's actually just outside of Whitefish, but very close. They're located adjacent to the Stillwater State Forest, and they have so many dogs and sleds, and it's just a beautiful and peaceful time in the winter with the snow falling, just gliding along and enjoying nature. And during the Whitefish Winter Carnival, residents can still enjoy ski joring. This event has taken place in Whitefish since the 1960s. It has moved from Central Avenue due to some close calls with horse and rider. But residents can still enjoy this as part of the festival. It's just a little further out now, giving the horses and riders space. But basically it's skiers that are pulled behind horses, and it's definitely a great time. You don't want to miss it. And if you or your children are into ice skating or hockey, there is the Stumptown Ice Den in Whitefish. This is an indoor ice rink, and they offer ice skating lessons. They offer hockey time on the rink, figure skating training, public skate opportunities, and party room rentals. And then as far as shopping and dining are concerned, Whitefish has many, many, many options in addition to art galleries and all this other stuff. So shopping and dining, the Village Inn, I didn't know this until actually researching for this video, but it's located in an old theater from downtown, which is pretty cool. But they have clothing and jewelry and shoes and handbags, so it's a fun place to check out. Merriweather, Montana Scene, the Toggery, Whitefish Quilts and Gifts. Not really my cup of tea, but there is a lot of huckleberry stuff in there, and if you are into quilting, definitely check them out. And then as far as activities are concerned, Glacier Cyclery and Nordic can get you outfitted with bikes for the season, and Stumptown Snowboards has stuff for all your snowboard needs. And then when it comes to dining, you will not be lacking for options here. Some of my favorites, the Farmhouse Inn and Kitchen. They are great for farm-to-table food. It's a very, very small little restaurant in there, but I absolutely love going if you can. When you visit or when you stay, check them out. And then the boat club restaurant at the lodge at Whitefish Lake. I just love the views here, honestly. You can sit on the deck or in the dining room and just enjoy the views over the lake and the mountain in the dining room. We usually go here for special occasions. It's a bit more expensive, but my husband loves the elk tenderloin here. They'll do huckleberry mud pie for special events like birthdays, anniversaries, that sort of thing. And then Chow Mambo's. I also featured them in my Whitefish Montana East Day Shop Play video, but they just have wonderful Italian food. It is difficult to get a seat here, so make reservations ahead of time or you could get takeout. I love the Italian nachos. I've never had anything like that anywhere else. Certainly not healthy, but definitely something that I crave. Also, their penne alla vodka or their linguine carbonara are really, really good. And of course, there are plenty more options. There's Mama Blanca's, there's some sushi, a new Mexican cantina type thing came in, a few different options for breakfast, the crepe place, Florida Bake Shop. So plenty of options in Whitefish for you guys. All right, you guys, so before we go into the pros and cons, I will let you know that Whitefish is definitely the most liberal of all the towns in Flathead County. So depending on how you feel about things, that could be a pro or a con. You can put it in that category as you see fit. So let's get into the pros and cons of choosing Whitefish over a different city in Flathead County. Whitefish is a quaint little town. It's incredibly walkable, which is wonderful for adults and students alike because a lot of the middle schoolers will get out of school and be able to walk or bike around town with their friends, and that's really fun. It's a really nice perk of the city. Additionally, they have the snow bus that can take students or adults up to the mountain for a day of fun. So as far as transportation is concerned, if you're just staying within the city, you could easily do that even without a vehicle if you didn't need to go anywhere else. And the train station is right there as well. The public high school and middle school are at or above the state average here, so that's awesome. And residents here don't have to go far to enjoy hiking, biking, skiing, snowshoeing, cross-country skiing, fishing, beaches. I can go on and on. There's plenty of recreational opportunities here. And if residents tire of what is right nearby, Whitefish, Montana is 33 minutes from the west entrance of Glacier National Park. So a huge playground, endless opportunities for recreation here. All right, so moving on to the cons. Whitefish, Montana is definitely the most expensive city to live within Flathead County. Your housing is gonna cost more here, your utilities, your taxes, both property, and then you have that tourist tax on anything that you buy. It's definitely going to cost a bit more. However, if you're able to walk different places and not have a vehicle or save some money that way, that may help a little bit. And while Whitefish, Montana is very close to Whitefish Mountain Resort and all that the city has to offer, it is farther from the things that Lakeside and Big Fork along Flathead Lake have to offer. Now, honestly, if you live in Whitefish, you probably don't really need to go to Lakeside or Big Fork. You have plenty of options there, so maybe that's not as big of a deal. But then you're also going to deal with tourists more. More tourists stay in Whitefish, Montana during summer and then also the winter months, usually between Christmas and New Year's, that holiday in there. The main thoroughfares do get backed up. You're going to need to be prepared to deal with that extra traffic. And then let's just do a quick rundown of commute times for you. So from just central downtown Whitefish, Montana, your commute time to Whitefish Mountain Resort is going to be 16 minutes. Your commute time to Kalispell is going to be 24 minutes. To Columbia Falls, you're also looking at a 16-minute commute time. To the west entrance of Glacier National Park, you're gonna be at 33 minutes. Your commute time to Lakeside is going to be 37 minutes. To Big Fork is 41 minutes. And then to Blacktail Mountain Ski Resort, you're looking at 66 minutes for your commute time there. Whitefish, Montana also does have a health facility, the Wave, where you can work out, gym, all that stuff. They also have Soba Cycle. They have Yoga Hive, so definitely some different various workout options for you. If just getting outside is not enough for you, you do have some indoor options. All right, you guys, I think that covers it. If I missed anything, leave a comment below. If you have any questions, go ahead and leave that below too. I love to hear from you guys. I hope you have an awesome week. Next week is going to be the walking tour of downtown Whitefish, so be sure to hit that notification bell so you get notified when that one drops. And then from there, we're gonna go to Columbia Falls and West Glacier, and then Big Fork and Crescent, and Lakeside and Summers, and Lower Valley. So stay tuned, have an awesome week, you guys, and I'll see you next time.